Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to FCWR Slamdown episode 20. And well, looks like we're starting off the night with the FC, the current and still FCWR champion after breakdown. It is indeed Cody Travers, who by hook or by crook retained his FCWR championship against Torin at breakdown. He had to clothesline the ref, give him a lariat, use a steel chair to retain his title at breakdown, and I'm sure he's gonna address this whole situation right here, right now, to start up episode 20 of FCWL Slam Down. Let's listen in. Come on, is that really necessary to add more of that? That is one pissed off Torin making his way to the ring right now. Oh dear. Whoa, so wait a minute, wait. We're gonna have Cody versus Torin right now to open episode 20? Impromptu match? And if Torin wins, he gets another shot in a no DQ match? It looks like that's what we're getting right now! And here we go! These two men right now! Beating each other up! I'm sure Torin struck a nerve by saying those things to Cody right now. And here we go, this matchup's on the way. Cody against Torin. And look at this, both trading blows right now. On an already stacked card here tonight, we're getting an impromptu match between Cody and Tolan right now. Episode 20 is up to a very, very interesting start. If Tolan's able to beat Cody right now, he will get another shot, this time in a no DQ match. Cody mentioned, oh man, mentioned how the time attack challenge is coming up soon. He said that no one will take the title away from him, and I really gotta doubt that, considering, oh, close down there from Toe, considering who's already in that time attack challenge. Remember, Rugo was qualified because he defeated Cody one-on-one back in that Pick Your Poison challenge. And on the last episode, we saw Roxas, we saw the Black Panther, and we saw Gambit qualify for that time attack challenge. We still got three open spots we're going to determine tonight, as the eighth spot is still held by a mystery opponent whose identity will be revealed at the event. Of course, our main event here tonight is a rivalry renewed, reignited. It's Yuya Sakura taking on Jaden Yuki for the final spot in the Time Attack Challenge. Look at this. Oh my God! Just sends him right into the barricade. And oh man, oh no, I think that was almost the balls. But this matchup also very important for Tauden. I thought Cody was gonna take the count out victory, but no. Goes back and throws Tauden back in the ring. I mean, Cody, he said it himself, he's gonna beat Tauden up right now after what he said. No mentioning Cody's good frenemy, it seems like, Guy, and Cody's former girlfriend Jessica. Was kind of fucked up to mention that from Tauden, but you know, Tauden isn't a saint either. Let's just say that. And now Tauden in trouble this match. Oh wait, I should not say that. Commentator's curse right there. And Toe, nice gut buster right to the gut. Knee to the gut of Cody Travers. And now gets neck breaker from Toe here. Here's a pinfall. 1, 2, and 3. No, not yet. Cody's still alive. Cody doesn't want to face Tauden again. I don't know if that's because he's scared or because he feels like he has already proven his point that he can beat Tauden. 1, 2, no! Even though it was via cheating using a steel chair. Tauden, oh, elevated neck break, inverted DDT, excuse me. Tauden going top rope. Is it going to be 450 splash? No, an elbow drop this time. Kind of surprised by that. Look at Tauden, does the knee right to the face. Tauden wants another shot. He feels like he's been screwed out of the title. Oh my god, that lariat is sure as hell powerful. Oh wait a minute, Shiny Girls on time. Yes, got it. Cody got it. Pinfall now, pinfall. 1, 2, and oh, not just yet. Cody now, knee right to your forehead, and another one. Thought he was gonna go for a third one. He doesn't. Cody now Irish whip. Oh my God, that face wash! Face wash. One, two, three. No, toe kicked out. Toe then kicked out. Oh my God, he's looking at the referee. Ref, you better go away. Do nothing this time. Thank God. But knowing why he did that breakdown. Oh, wait a minute. Holding with the snapmare here. Could he miss whatever he was going for there? But oh, get another close. I tell you what, Cody is vicious with those clotheslines. He's a vicious opponent, that's for sure. Current FCWR champion. Trying to make sure he doesn't face Toden once again. Moonsault, he got it! He got it, it's over. One, two, three. Oh my God! Toden barely got the shoulder up. Oh my God, the second Shining Wizard. Oh, I got another Shining Wizard. Cody now, oh boy. I think I know what he's going for. Oh yeah. Here we go. Cody, Ruffian, kick. Oh, Toled, moved out of the way. Toled now. Oh, wait a minute. He's got him all the way to the neck. Knee right to the neck. And now, he's got him up again. Oh, here we go. Super pushing. Super pushing. Got caught off guard with the super pushing. One, two, three. Got him. He got him. Toled just beat Cody here tonight on episode 20 of Slapdown. It took three super pushes back at breakdown, and Cody still was able to get up, but tonight he got caught off guard. Toled was able to hit that knee to the neck and then the super pushing right there, as you can see. And Cody got caught off guard, and Toled got the three count. Toled will get another shot in a no DQ match for the FCWL Championship. Oh my God, this doesn't bode well for Cody, I'll tell you that much. Toled will get another shot at the title. Wow. Well, that's one way to start the episode, huh? Welcome back to Slamdown, and I'll tell you what, Tolen and Yo Asakura looks ready for tonight's main event against Jaden Nuki. What the hell? What the hell is this? Well, we didn't saw them last episode, but here they are. Your new FCWR Tag Team Champions, Lugo Bernstein, Yuri Agami, Team KOF, and I don't see Kyo anywhere. I mean, considering what happened to Kyo, not only at Breakdown, but also at UCWL, testing the limit. I was there on commentary for that, actually. I'm not surprised it's not good. Kyo is probably in a hospital bed right now. I'm just saying. Team KOF runs scheduled to come out here right now. So maybe they're gonna address this. So, let's hear it. Well, it looks like someone doesn't care if you're a god or not, because here comes the Rock. Rock, who ever since debuting here at FCWL has had beef with Team KOF. Last time we saw him, he defeated Yuri Agami in one-on-one action. And I said it after that match that probably next on that list is Kyo Kusunagi, but he's injured right now, so I don't know. Watch out! No! Oh no! Oh no! Here we go again. This is the same shit. Oh, that these two always seems to do, or even this. We all jump on Genocide Cutter. And the single one now. Rockhawk came out here. Laid down the challenge, laid down the challenge to his competition. Oh, what is Yuri doing right now? Well, no, oh my god! Rockhawk came out here, he said, how are you gonna dominate FCWL? If you're only two men. Said he wants to beat some sense to Kyo in the past as well. right now he's getting double teamed by Yuri and Rugal. Is anyone gonna stop this? I have no idea. Oh no, he's setting him up for it. He's setting him up for it. No. Top rope genocide cutter. Damn it to hell. Oh, look at Yuri now. Purple fire. God damn it. This is not right at all. Rockhawk trying to make a name for himself here. And trying to beat some sense into a lost man, in my opinion, in Kyoko Tsunagi. I mean, I get it, you want the name KOF to be recognized. But oh, look at Rockhawk trying to make a comeback right now. Rockhawk, don't break those eyes. Look at Rockhawk, saving my point. Oh no, damn it. Headbutt by Rugal, and I'm Yuri already back in the ring. I get it, you want the name KOF to be recognized, respected. But that's not the way to go about it. Not only that, manipulating Rugal into accepting that and forcing Yuri to stay in that group. Although right now he doesn't seem to mind it that much anymore. This is not right at all. Oh, sweat on. Oh, is no one. There are no security right now. Or any talent that can come around here and stop this. Damn it. Rockhawk getting the beating of his life right now. This is a former Glitch Pit champion, god damn it. This is a man who went to oh my god. This is a man who went toe-to-toe against Super Mario, god damn it. And that's how you treat him. That's how you treat this man. For the love of God. Oh, wait a minute. Rockhawk. No. Oh, god damn it. The numbers game. Another purple fire. This is sickening. This is absolutely sickening. And another goddamn genocide cutter. God damn it. God damn it to hell. I hope you're proud of yourselves. Yuri and Rugal standing tall. And then they get beaten. Rockhawk outside there. He can barely stand up right now. God damn it. Coming up next, folks, is our first time attack qualifying match of the night. As Bryce Denis is in for a long night. That's for them. So considering who his opponent is, I'm not gonna say who it is yet. But I'm pretty sure once Bryce's entrance is finished, you will know exactly who he is. Bryce, he's gonna have to put everything on the line to qualify here tonight. And I'm not putting that lightly. I am certain of it. I mean, he said it himself, he wants to be a more serious competitor in FCWL, just like Sanji is currently, and trying to be currently as well.
je vous conseille. Pas très bien compris, il y a juste assez pour un film.
But, yeah. If he wants a shot at the SCWR Championship, if he wants to qualify the Time Attack Challenge, he's gonna have to go through one game. Man, I should have known I would get into the afternoon tonight. God damn it. And this infamous song. The mood has changed here. Episode 20 of SmackDown. All the stuff is still changing. What is it? Hard. Down in the area that might be the way to the ring, but it's Australia who's going to be this Time Attack Cross Fight. I have no idea why they put him in. Why they even gave him a chance to qualify. He's trying to take over this organization. He's trying to take over FCWR with Zana and Arn. And he already took out Hurwick. We haven't seen Hurwick. We haven't seen the Hurwick since breakdown. Odd beat him in the match. And we haven't heard a single thing from him ever since. And you mean to tell me that's how they're gonna treat or they're gonna think William and Odd by giving them a chance to actually succeed? 16 in their goal? I'll tell you what, this board of directors sometimes, I questioned them more times than I could think. William's out here. And that's why I said that Bryce is in for the fight of his life here tonight. We saw what William is capable of in the past. And here we go. This matchup's what? Did you get the power outage? The hell's going on? What the hell's going on right now? Oh my! I just heard a thud. I just heard something. What the hell? And wait. What the hell? What? What the hell just happened? What? William wins, but he's qualified for the Time Attack Challenge. What the hell just happened?
I hope this doesn't get copyrighted. Hey guys, I will be hosting the spokesperson audition for the new AWF commercial. So let's see what you guys got. Best of luck to all of you.
Okay, motherfuckers, I'm multi-time champion Mason Chronic, and I'm here to talk to you about some fucking anime.
This is an AWF commercial.
The fuck do you mean this is an AWF commercial?
I think I've heard this one before. Next.
Where should I star in a new AWF commercial? Let's be real. I'm the Big Mac, the Ben Hopkins brand. It's a Hopkins thing you wouldn't understand. I'm bloody great. So. See, this is contract. It has my terms. It has my working dates as well, and my fee. So I guess it's safe for me to sign and get my money, right?
I'm gonna pass. Next.
Ladies and gentlemen, AWF, your favorite car wrestler is here. The Boat, ladies and gentlemen. The Boat, Sean O'Connor, myself.
Next.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Call of Thirst champion is in the AWF. Are you going to join the hunt?
Whoa. You mean to tell me you didn't ask your AWF World Heavyweight Champion to be your spokesperson? Man, I'm going back to ACCE. Shane Walsh would never do me like this.
Hey, how about you bitches shut the fuck up? I'm over here trying to watch some AWF. Fuck, man. Jeez.
Everyone used the time I chat challenge. I'll tell you about it. What the hell is this music? Oh my god, she actually showed up. This woman actually showed up. I wonder if she wasn't gonna show up here tonight. She'll get sued by me personally. King just appeared here on episode 20. She better have a damn good explanation for herself here. Because of her, there's one seat empty in the board of directors. Because of this woman right here. You better have a damn good explanation, woman. Because I'll tell you what. Only one thing keeping me from going to this ring and confronting you, and that's my commentary duty. And this crowd just burned the hell out of her. And she seems to like it. What the hell? Embracing those dudes here tonight. Whoa. Why are you bringing my name up? Turn the microphone right now. Turn the microphone right now. Oh, for the love of God. Listen, it's not because I said that I was automatically gonna call you back. There were other candidates. Oh yeah, I hope you're damn proud of that. Yeah, you're not gonna be here for long, that's for damn sure. That's for damn sure. What? Wait, Curry Warrior music? The hell? The Curry Warrior's gonna come out there and confront King? Well, I don't know what. Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god, holy shit! It's Leo the Hydron! It's Leo the Hydron! A member of the Akari Warriors as well! Why is she here? King is shocked! Why is Leo the Hydron here? What the hell's going on here tonight on episode 20 of Slamdown? Leo the Hydron is here in FCWL! But why? Folks, coming up next, it is the Time Attack qualifying match and also the International Championship being defended at the same time. It's Tony Parker taking on Travis Touchdown. Tony Parker finally getting his shot at the title. Guys, I cannot believe that. First of all, King coming out here talking about this design isn't supposed to be her boy. But then Leona Hyder made her appearance here. She made her appearance on stage. And I don't know why she's here. I have really no idea why she's here. I might have to ask Ralph Jones and Doug Steele. Because I literally have no idea why Leona Hyder showed up here tonight. Right, your peeps were so wrong, your team is overhyped, your leader must be LeBron. I'm a different like species completely. We just happy at all about teams and he sees. Yup, but that's enough for your official death. Leona Hyder is one of the deadliest soldiers you'll ever encounter. But right now we got the International Championship match on deck here. It is Tony Parker taking on this man, quite arguably the face of this company. It is the current FCWR International Champion, the current DCA Celestial Champion. It's Travis Touchdown! Travis, always a fighting champion, taking on all comers, even though As of late, he has had, well, problems, not only in DCA, but even here in FCWL, and his brother Henry actually thinks that he is involved with all the stuff that's happening in DCA. I'm not getting into deep into that conversation, because otherwise we'd be here for about 20 minutes. But Travis, you know, everybody's accusing him of having a hand in everything that's going on over there. But I talked to the man, I've asked him about 3 times already. He said he had nothing to do with it. And I actually think that this entire situation could, you know, impact Travis Touchdown's performance in the ring. I think he could impact his performance. And if, I tell you what, if Tony Parker takes advantage of even one little small mistake that Travis makes here tonight, he will walk out as the international champion. He looks determined, that's for sure. But Travis doesn't look phased at all. Travis, like I said, fighting champion always has been. Whatever title he's holding. Defends it against any comer, anyone that wants a shot. Showing the belt to Tony Parker here. And showing the belt down to the crowd. As the International Championship is about to be defended. And the spot as well in the Time Attack Challenge. That's big. Whoever wins here tonight is walking out with both. And I'll tell you what, this could mean that the international champion could become the world champion and become the first double champion in FCWR history. But they would have a long way to go. Win this match for the night, first of all. Then win the Time Attack Challenge, which is not going to be easy at all. And look at Tony Parker here with a chip shot. And Travis, oh my god. Rolling punch. Travis certainly not in the good mood, considering the accusation, the words of Henry last episode with this close. I missed. I know. Oh my god! Turned him inside out. 1, 2, 3, no! Travis must be in a pissed off mood, considering what Henry said on the last episode. Considering how annoyed he was by Tony Parker as well on the last episode. And also considering what happened recently at the 6-year anniversary show over at DCA. Travis must be in a pissed off mood tonight. But like I said, win this match here tonight. Win the Time Attack Challenge, which isn't going to be easy. Gonna have the fastest time at Time Attack. 1, 2, kick out there. Gonna have the fastest time, and then you gotta win the world title. Actually win it at Fight for Victory. And if you have international championship matches, title defenses along the way, it's gonna be a very, very long road if one of these two wants to become the first double champion in FCWR history. Travis, coming to the ropes. Oh, look at this. Oh no, Tony Parker, excuse me. Jawbreaker right there. And there's a rolling elbow. Yeah, it's gonna be a long road. for either one of these two men. Once again, a lot of them on the line here. Tony, oh, he missed that. Oh, nice close line there. Tony Parker, one, two, no, oh, not even two count. Oh, punch block there. And look at Travis now. Travis, belly to belly. Travis now. Calling Tony Parker back up. Stun gun around the ropes. Travis now. He's gonna look for something. Is he gonna look for the bit? No. Tony Parker got up. Stopping dead at his tracks here. Parker now. What the hell is this? Oh, punch to the gut. It just pushes him down. Oh, right on the arm there. And now Travis in control of this match. Russian leg sweep. Travis now by re-strip to the corner. And now sends him to the other side. Now Travis. Northern Lights. Perfectly executed right there. One, two, and no. Cody Parker still got some life left in him. Oh, kick was missed there. Bulldog. Moved up from Tony Parker here. And now clotheslines him outside the ring. Tony. Oh man. Right there. Oh! Forearm right to the head. No, Tony, very underrated talent here at FCWL. Finally getting a shot at a title. He beat Kyokuzunagi twice. And he's been on quite a roll ever since appearing here for the first time. A little bit goofy, but still. A talent to watch out for. Travis, he'll be damned if he's gonna let someone outshine him here tonight. Big time splash! Oh! He got him with the head, but he's dead! I mean, Travis hurt himself a little bit there as well. But he got the beat of the headbutt there. Was going for a big time splash, but he got more of a headbutt. Oh my god, another one! No, this time! Tony Parker moved out of the way. Tony, oh, nice sliding clothesline there. Very fast, very quick, and very athletic. That's who Tony Parker is, and look at this. Nice punch there, sends him down. Oh my god, he's gonna look for it. He's looking for it. Ball in, elbow drop. Balling elbow drop right there, right on Travis touchdown. One, two, three, no. And Tony is pissed. Travis got the shoulder up. Tony is a little bit pissed about that. But Tony, drive by, no. That was blocked. Sends him down there. And look at this, single leg busted crab. Santa Destroy Crab right there. Or Boston Crab. He goes, you know. And, oh wait a minute, Tony Parker right back up. Tony, clothesline. And another one. Oh, he tried to go for a kick. But he gets the legs whipped right there by Tony Parker. And Tony now. Oh my god, he's gonna look for a second one. The second ball in. Ball in. Elbow drop. Ball and elbow drop, and now he's going to the top rope. Oh boy. Oh boy, Tony Parker to the top rope. Oh, leg drop. Nice leg drop right there. Goes directly for the pinfall. We could have a new champion. 2-3, no. Not yet. Not yet for Tony. Drop kick to the back. Tony right now wondering what he has to do. And he's might setting him up for the drive-by kick. No! Michinoku driver! Michinoku driver! And now, Ayushu to the corner there. Oh, that was blocked. Travis with the punch. And an uppercut! An uppercut! Ugh. Travis to the top rope. Travis, big time splash! He got it! Finally got all of it! Pinfall, 1, 2, 3, oh my, oh man! Tony, at the last second, getting the shoulder up. Tony wants that title, he wants that spot in the time attack challenge. But Travis not gonna let it happen. Oh, that was blocked there from Tony. Tony now. Oh man, he missed that. Missed whatever he was going for there. And oh, right into the turnbuckle. And oh my god. Punch right there. Wait a minute. Dragon suplex. Or tiger suplex. Got him very good here. Wait a minute, Brainbuster! Brain, no! Tony saw it coming, and Tony now! Tony, drive-by kick! Drive-by kick! Tony Parker with the drive-by kick! New champion! And going to the time attack challenge! Tony freaking Parker! Wow! What? Travis kicked out right there. Oh my god, yeah, right to the leg there. Right to the leg, what a match here. Oh, jumping knee. What a match here on episode 20. Oh wait a minute, another one, another drive-by kick. Another drive-by kick! And Travis got busted open from that one! Come on, Tony, go for the pinfall! Oh, he's going for it! Oh, oh my god! Oh! The athleticism of Travis with that enziguri avoided a pinfall attempt! Travis very proud of that counter, and look at that neck breaker. That neck breaker right there. What a damn good match we are seeing right here. Travis picking Tony Parker back up. One for pitches here. Cruise, I missed. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, wait. He's going to get got again. Oh! He got got again with that clothesline stand up again. Turned him inside out again. To the corner, Tony Parker goes. To the top rope he goes now. Travis touchdown. Superplex, maybe. Oh no no no! Oh no no no! No no no! Brainbuster! On the turnbuckle! and that sets up usually for the real Brain Buster. And wait, oh my god, I haven't seen this move in years. Oh my god, touchdown! Travis, using an old trick in the book, the touchdown! That burning hammer, 1, 2, 3, and Travis retains and goes to the time attack challenge. Woo! Wow! What a match here tonight. I'll tell you what, Tony Parker was game, a very game Tony Parker here tonight. But Travis once again proving yet again why he is one of the fastest rising star in car wrestling today. Travis retains the title and goes to the time attack challenge. The first step to becoming a double champion for him has been the success, but can he really do it? We'll find out on Main Event is up next.
Select the one to fight with. Get it on 10-9-8-7-6. Think and choose the right one. Get it on 5-4-3-2-1. Yeah. Select the one to fight with. Get it on 10-9-8-7-6.
Yes, sir.
Think and choose the right one. Get it on 5-4-3-2-1. It's time for you to get into the character. You hit a loser, hit a win, I'm only asking you. Either you beat him or you beat him like an amateur. Either you drive or you get driven like a passenger. The fight's around the corner, so pick the one you want to. Represent your way, go head to head with your opponent. Feel it in the air, tension is electric. The glory's imminent, this is something epic. It's for one of you, so what you gonna do? When your enemy is standing right in front of you, are you gonna lose, or are you gonna prove to everyone that never thought you would that you could? Cause everything is in your hands, you control it. And everything that is the past, it is over. This is now, this is everything that is. So you better make the right pick. Select the one to fight with.
Get it on
10-9-8-7-6. Pick and choose the right one.
Get it on
5-4-3-2-1. Select the one to fight with.
Get it on
10-9-8-7-6. Pick and choose the right one.
Get it on
5-4-3-2-1.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are reached the end of this evening here tonight. What a show it has been. Slam Down episode 20. And we are going to end up this show with a reigniting rivalry here tonight. Was on the first episode of Slamdown that this man Jay the Nuki interrupted the at the time first ever and new FCWL champion Yoa Sakura. Then he got lucky in the semi-finals of the FCWL championship tournament when they both faced off for the first time. Then it went on to a rivalry which got personal with Jaden's World talking about Yoa Sakura's wife and to an extent family as well. They faced off at Inception for the world title for the first time. Yoa Sakura came out on top, the rivalry continued all the way into Sleepy Falls. Well, oh god! All the way to Sleepy Falls in a 2 out of 3 falls match. Yoa Sakura again won that match even though Jaden was able to get a pinfall during the match. And it was thanks to that victory that Jaden was able to challenge for the SWF Championship as long as Rio Sakura held it. But now, Rio Sakura lost the title to Cody. Both men are chasing the same goal here. They want the SWF Championship. Rio Sakura wants to be a two-time champion, make history. So that is me, my chosen pocket. If he wants to use it, he said he wants to prove and to deserve that rematch. But let's not forget that he still has that rematch strong if he wants to. Jaden, he wants to put the nail in the coffin. Rio Sakura to prove once again that he always was a step ahead. Even though Rio Sakura always won the matches, he wants to prove that he was a step ahead. This is a rivalry that basically started FCWR. And now, on episode 20, this rivalry is here yet again. This crowd waiting for one of these two to make the first move, and here we go, Colorado tie up here. Jaden on the out now, and Jaden a knee right there, and oh, right to the arm, elbow to the arm there, and again another elbow to the arm of Rio Sakura. Rio Sakura in trouble now and let it go. And look at Jaden again. Always been a mastermind of mind games. Playing with the emotions of his opponents, especially when he faces Rio Sakura. Colorado tie up once again. Jaden again with the upper hand here. Jaden as of late, like he said earlier tonight, been dealing with the Black Panther, which led to a tag team match at Breakdown involving these two men and Hisoka and the Black Panther. A match where, oh, dropkick right to the knee there. A match that Black Panther and Rio Sakura were able to win on that night. But this is one-on-one. This is no tag team match. And there's that bicycle kick, that trademark bicycle kick that you've been using forever. There's only a one count though. Only a one count. Knife edge drop, he rolled out. And oh my god! That jumping knee right there. One, two, no. Again, one count for both men. Forearm block there from Jaden. Forearm block from Yo. Forearm block from Jaden here. Forearm block from Yo there. He finally gets a shot in with the forearm. And now Jaden does as well. No, it's blocked again. And there's an uppercut. Forearm again. Uppercut again. Irish whip sides under. And there's that hurricane rana. Rio Sakura, I mean, actually you could say for both men, fast competitors, high flyer, especially Jaden, really high flying offense from him. That's exactly what we're doing right now. Oh, he missed that springboard frog splash. And there's, oh, nice leg scissors takedown there. I thought he was going for an enziguri of some sort. Jaden trying to get back up to his feet though. Northern Lights! One, two, three. Oh no, kick out. one of the Yuya Sakura's signature moves here, the Northern Light Suplex. Oh, there's an elbow there from JJ. Oh, he missed that kick there. And yo, neck breaker. Neck breaker from Yo right there. Final spot in the time attack challenge on the line. As you know, the eighth man will be a mystery opponent. Like I said, we'll find out who it will be at the event itself. Also, I've just had confirmation that the no DQ match between Torren and Cody for the FCWR Championship will happen at Time Attack. Time Attack is already shaping up to be one big event for FCWR. Look at Jaden though. Jaden, oh my god! Tope Card Hero. And Jaden proud of his work here. There's a neck breaker on the outside. Like I said, so far the members, the participants for the Time Attack Challenge, Hugo, the Black Panther, Gambit, Roxas, William, Travis Touchdown, and one of these two here tonight will qualify as the mystery opponent. Oh my god, that was a bad landing there for Jaden. One of these two and then the mystery opponent. Time Attack shaping up to be one of the most spectacular events in FCWL as we are on the road to fight for victory, the season finale. Tiger Bomb from Jaden, signature move of his. 1, 2, no! Yo, able to kick out. He's been hit with that Tiger Bomb so many times, he knows how to kick out of it. Oh, but wait a minute, Jaden, no. Oh, nice move there from Yo. He walled out to his, on his belly there, so he couldn't be hit with the Tiger Bomb. But Jaden still gonna jump. Oh, oh, Hurricane Rana there. 1, 2, and there's a world break from Yo. World break there from Yo Asakura. Oh man, slamming his face into the turnbuckle. Oh god, he's gonna run towards the corner there. Jaden, oh, he's planning for, oh! Big running uppercut. Uppercut, oh! Sorry, excuse me about that. Jaden, oh man, oh! Punch right to the back. There's a back suplex. I mean, like we said, rivalry, this rivalry, well documented. These two know each other so well in the ring. It's going to be hard for one of these two to find out an opening, a big opening to finish their opponents here tonight. As you can see, they're just going back and forth. One big move after another. Yuya Sakura and Jaden Newkey both want to go to the Time Attack Challenge, potentially go to the main event, a fight for victory. Oh man, shooting star press, no! Yo moved out of the way. Kick to the gut there. Oh my god, oh my god, sunset flip! Shaman Bomb! Here's a pin for 1, 2, 3, no! Jaden scouted also. Yosakura's moves there. Oh, oh my god, spinning kick there. Jaden already back up. 1, 2, and no! Like I said, both of these men, they know each other so well. They know each other's signature moves. Yeah, you run out of the ring. Oh my God! Jaden still jumped. I'll tell you what. If there's one thing I know about Jaden Newkey, is that every time he faces against Yuya Sakura, somehow, some way, he's putting his body on the line. That's his determination to beat Yuya Sakura. Tiger Bomb here. Oh, oh my God! Oh my God! Right on the monitor! Oh my God! He could have broke Yuya Sakura's back here with that Tiger Bomb on the monitor. Oh my God, oh my God, again on the monitor! Jaden Newkey could have easily taken that count out victory, but no! He wants to put the exclamation point on this whole entire thing between him and Yuya Sakura. He could have broke Yuya Sakura's back on that monitor. That was sick! In a bad way! Right now, he's on that table. Oh my God, no. No, 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 no. What the hell are you doing, Jaden? What the hell are you doing? Oh my God, no, 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 Tiger Bomb for the table! Tiger Bomb for the table! It's over. It's over. Yuya Sakura's back must be scrambled right now. 1, 2, and 3. How? And you can see Jaden almost fended the referee right there. How is he still about to kick out? There's that combination there from Jaden. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God! The leg is not supposed to bend that way. Oh, double foot stop and a kick. Oh wait a minute, you're still fighting somehow! Uppercut! Yuya Sakura will not be denied! Super Shaman Kick! Ah. 1, 2, 3, no! Jaden's still alive! How is Yuya Sakura even walking still? He took a Tiger Bomb into a monitor! A Tiger Bomb through the table! Oh, Jaden grabs the weakened leg! Dragon screw there and there's a stomp right to the face. Kick to the back. My God, what a main event so far for episode 20. These two right now. Oh no, Jaden's about to ruin the good match right now. He's got a steel chair. Don't do this, you'll be disqualified. Referee making the good decision, taking the chair away from him. Yuri's back up. Oh my God! Saw it coming with that elbow there, right to the face. And oh my God, what is this? Oh! Counting into two DDT, and I think Yuya Sakura's busted open. Yuya Sakura got busted open from that elbow there. Yuya Sakura there. Oh! Counted into an arm drag! Jaden has counted Yuya Sakura. How can you defeat him in here tonight? I mean, Yuya Sakura said it earlier tonight that Jaden has to get his game on if he wants to have any chance to defeat him here tonight again on the weakened leg. And I'll tell you what, Jaden Newkey has his game on here tonight. He has his damn game on here tonight. Another Tiger Bomb! He's going for it. He is going for it. Shooting star press. Will you be able to avoid it? He did! He avoided it! He knows that combination all too well. And you're right now, what is this? Oh my god! Oh my god, that's the move Jaden Yuki tapped out to in the past! The Shaman Vice! Shaman Vice locked in right now! You're trying this damnness to make Jaden tap out once again! Oh, but Jaden quickly gets out of it! I mean, you can see he's bleeding! Oh my god, the knee again! Yuasakura busted open and all! Losing a lot of blood, he must have barely any energy left. Oh, look at him still trying to put up a fight. Oh my god, get to the gut there. Oh no, Sunset Flip, Shaman Bomb again. Sunset Flip, Shaman Bomb again. And you, oh, Jaden getting back up. Oh, wait a minute, he was up for another one. Spinning heel kick. Getting him back up. But no, you're still fighting. You're still fighting. DDT. After all the punishment he's been through this match. He's been through in this match. He's still putting up a fight against Jaden Yuki, his arch rival here on FCWL. What a main event for episode 20 here. A world tribute here. Oh my god, Tiger Bomb again! That's like the fifth or the fourth one in this entire match. He's gonna try again! He's gonna try and get that combination, but yo, he's getting up. Oh, elbow drop, he missed again. You scouted that. You knows it all too damn well. And wait a minute, what the hell? He still comes out there. What the hell? He just distracted Yuasakura. No! No, god damn it, no! He still comes out here. Yuasakura trying to get back into it. Oh, Sunset Flip, Shaman Bomb again! Said no! No! Jaden able to counter it! Some punches there! Oh! That leg sweep there! That leg sweep right there! Jaden Yuki go to the top rope! No! Not this way! Shooting star press! One! Two! Three! God damn it! No! After a match, who will be remembered in the history books here at FCWL? That's how he wins! He took out the field in his favor! Came down here, distracting Yo for about 10 seconds only, and that was enough! For Jaden to hit the shooting star press. Oh my god, that impact again. Tiger Bomb on the monitor and then on the table. That's how Jaden qualifies for the time attack challenge, ladies and gentlemen. I am not happy about this, and this crowd is a taver. But folks, that's how this night ends. That's how episode 20 ends here tonight.